We got the Thrasher January 2017 issues here. There are two covers. This is a Kyle Walker on the cover, Dylan cover on this one. Dude, look at that. Fucking gnarly. Chris Russell, nose grain tail grab. Welcome to the pro ranks, Chris. Two burly fucking photos, or, well, you know, cover, and then Jesus Christ. Yeah, dude, welcome to Crooked, Matt. Okay, page three. Brutal backside 50-50, kink after kink. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Seven kinked rail. Yeah, dude, welcome to 2017. Oh, man. Dude, this... this issue is just fucking hitting. Justin Brock switched tray flip into this bank. God, dude, the first five pages is like getting jumped into a gang. Chima. Yeah, that's switch, dude. Gap to switch front board. And it doesn't say. Switch ollie, switch front board down that thing. Woo. Awesome photo. Look at that face. Yeah, just epic, epic human. Louis Lopez. Damn, that's gnarly too, because you gotta pop back into that thing. Oh, BA, welcome to the fucking 1-8. So yeah, I was talking to Brian 2 weeks ago, and he was like super excited for this ad to come out. He was so excited, and I told him I was gonna get the issue, and I was gonna take these two pages out and put them in a frame and put them on the wall. Larry from management says, the first time I ever saw Brian skate, I wanted to give him boards. I chickened out because Antihero was still pretty new, and I knew there was a Slashdog perception of us, and he was kind of tech, but powerful, and I just chickened out. Plus, he had two or three Toy Machine stickers on his car. Well, it only took 16 years or so, but thanks for giving Antihero a shot, Brian. I could just hear Brian's super deep voice like, what, dude? I like Madonna, so what? Fuck yeah, Brian. Two-page Elijah, and I'm guessing that he scooched off that steep-ass bank to grind on that thing. That's like a titty-high Wally fucking jumper. Yeah, fuck yeah. Dude, Elijah's the best. Sourpuss in the mail drop, gender bender. Dude, I love that Anthony is always, like, sneaking. He's always down here somewhere in the mag. I can just hear him like, oh, dude. Ben Rayburn refuses to comply. Fakey 43 in the face of convention. Holy fuck, man. Yeah, look at that. Booznitz. Two-page sequence, 10 years of Booznitz. So he's doing a backside lip-slide kickflip forward on this ledge. He fucking manhandles that kickflip. If you get pitched or you stick, you're fucked. Fuck yeah, Dennis. Look at this fucking thing. What the fuck? It's like a cobblestone vert ramp. Look at that shit. What a fucking sick photo. Jesus, Kyle Walker's fucking gnarly. Dude. Come from here, backsmith, then jump over the wall here onto the, what the, Jesus Christ. Okay, we got Jaws here. Just, he's going somewhere far. He's going somewhere far. Look how dipped that fucking Smith grind is. Some people don't like that. I love those. I love when you're lapped over the other side on a rail. Mason Silva, that's a cool photo. You come from here and go that way. Jesus. Fuck yeah, Mason Silva. Jesus, front three over that thing. Lunatic fringe. Look how fucking dipped that is. Fuck, man, that thing's like 7 feet tall. Coming from here, front feeble, and then transferring over to the other side. Just dipped. Pull up a bongo and you'll realize this is a sensitive skater unafraid to share a story. And here we have another one of Ed Templeton's genius advertisements for Blake Carpenter. Ed, you should put a book out at some point. Make a Toy Machine ad. Coffee table book. Make it just so I can buy one, please. He hides the coolest stuff in his ads. If you know what to look for, and he's been doing these ads for so fucking long, these are some of the best ads ever. Wage jihad on skate spots with Toy Machine. Oh my God. Funeral French. That's rad. I love the fact that they do those canvases. Here we go. Enough said. Jesus, dude. That's a fucking heavy lineup. Fucking love. Fucking awesome. And then... this is what it looks like when there's a bit of like a quiet time in your head, like on a tour or on a fucking filming trip. That's what it looks like when you're able to stop and take it all in and fucking realize what the fuck you're doing and how magical it is. Wow, this issue is, dude. Oh, there we go. Yep. It's like, this is what we do, and it means everything, and it's fucking amazing.
God, that's fucking gnarly, dude.
That's probably one of the best 6 pages back to back in a magazine ever. Figgy and Colin, fucking sick. Colin Provost is one of the gnarliest fucking skateboarders I've ever seen with my own two eyes.
Whew.
This is like a Dylan tribute piece here. Just look at that, man. That's what it looks like. And that's what it just fucking looks like. We lost one of the most influential and talented skaters of this era. For as naturally gifted as Dylan was, he also had the drive to match it. He was truly born to ride a skateboard. He lived his life to the fullest and would do anything for his friends. The last 2 years, I watched him fight the hardest battle life could throw at you. 3 weeks before he passed, he was talking to me with a grin on his face about what it was going to feel like to fall on concrete again when he got back on his board. Cancer and all the hard shit he went through never broke his spirit. He was a warrior to the end. I'm honored to have shared some of this life with such a great person. He taught me so much. I miss him every day, but I know I will see my brother again. Anthony Van Engelen. That's what a man looks like. That's how a man lives his life. So this is like some pages with stories and quotes about Dylan. Arto does one, Alex Olson does one, Sean Pablo, Mark Oblo. Wow. God. Austin Gillette, William Strobeck. This is what Bill Strobeck says. It was crazy to see how in awe girls were when they were around Dylan. If I ran into some chicks on the street, I'd text Dylan, "Where you at? Wanna link up?" And the shit was like watching a movie when he'd show up. I'd just stare at the females to see how much they'd change their shit up when they were in his presence. There were more than a few times when out of nowhere, I'd get a random text from a girl I hadn't heard from in years saying, "Hey, how you been doing? So what's up with your boy Dylan? Is he single?" Yeah, he had an amazing life. Dude, I saw that one time too. Oh my God, T-Pud's backside lip slide, just tink, 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 tink. Look at that, backside lip slide, just look at that photo of Jake. Zoom in on that. Yeah, dude, fuck. Just serrated gnarliness everywhere. Dude, just look at that, so contorted. Oh my God. I could have been the next Matt Hoffman. With braids blown in the wind, Dane grabs El Toro by the horns and back 5-0s into the fucking montages.
Yep.
Jesus Christ.
And then he just airwalks the fucking mega ramp. Airwalks the mega ramp. He's fucking, he's grinding the roof of a building. He's grinding the fucking roof of a building.
That's it, I'm done skating ledges, dude. I'm fucking done. Let the hippie ride.
Van's back in the van, look at these fucking pants. Dude, can you see that? Quilted corduroy. Dude, who is that?
Being in a van next to Dill, it was 0 to 100 real fast. K-walk lip slides.
Hold on. Now fucking look at this. Look at, can you see? Okay, look how long that shit is. Did he fucking lip slide the whole thing? Dude, this whole issue, Elijah Burl by Tony Alva.
Wow. Nose grind tail grab over the hip of a pool. Fakey 50-50 on that curve. It's like the church rail. They call it the church rail.
And then he ollie impossibles a titty high fucking bar off a bump. Look at that shit. Where's that frame at?
These two frames right here. If you stood there, that's solar plexus. You gotta wrap it and get it the fuck up in the air. That's like a trick. You either got it or you don't.
Oh, motherfucker. Damn it.
All right, dude. So I think this is spot and sack. It's that weird tranny to bar.
He does a frontside nose grind, nollie flip out, back into the transition.
Oh, fuck, man. Jesus, Elijah. Power to the people. Fuck. Alec Majerus, holy shit. He's doing a switch front crook. One of those dudes where you're like, that's the future. Ooh, the Descendants. We got an interview with the Descendants for Zounds. People get spoon-fed the truth from whatever their favorite biased news media source is. Game over, that's what it is. De La Soul, yep. That's a fuck, dude, this issue is heavy. Oh my God, they put a photo of me in here. Oh, Jesus Christ. Look at that. What the fuck am I doing with a hammer in my hand? Every issue of this magazine, Jerry has his little head is saying something. We were just talking about when he went into the dark room with a wine opener intending to stab Neen. Jerry Sue recalling Nandez's darker days. Gilbert Crockett, my girl got me into weed and rap. Okay, here we go. Here's a good one. Tyler Manchild Pacheco. I used to jerk off to Hubba Wheels ads. What happened to Hubba Wheels? Yep, zoom in on that one right there. Can you like get close to that one? Ooh, Jose Rojo, firing line. What up, Jose? I think I was there that day. Worst run-up in the history of fuck. Besides yesterday, that spot's the worst fucking run-up. Dude, another titty high. Wow. Yep, Drehobel with the something else. What's he doing? Oh my God, he just gets fucking washing machine right there. Just the tumble cycle right there. Fuck. Look at his fucking face. Yeah, he got worked. Dude, skateboarding is pretty, oh, Bobby Worst, fuck yeah. Here is the back cover. Now, I'm guessing this is Dylan in 2008 or 2009, the end of Minefield days. His family is starting a foundation, and it's DylanReaderFoundation.org. Yeah, dude, that's so crazy. Wow, dude, that, these are fucking good. Look at this other one. K-Walks again. I mean, if he didn't bend the rest of the issue over and fucking look at that. He's going from here all the way over there and then landing way out here. Yeah. This is one of the best skateboard magazines I've seen in a long, long, long time. Like everything in the magazine is fucking phenomenal. The people that they interview, all the photos, it's nuts. Yeah, both covers are fucking gnarly. That's rad, that's fucking awesome.